morning, Phoenix High School. I'm Isaac McDaniel. Welcome to PHTV.
And I'm Riley Nichols. Thank you for watching PHTV Newscast number 6. Advisors, after PHTV, hand out the Community 101 survey to all your students. Once they finish the survey, staff, please take the completed surveys to the basket and staff in the back of the staff workroom.
A week from today, we have picture retakes. Let's take a look at a segment Chris Belfield and Kaylin McRae made.
What's up?
Not much, man.
How's things going?
Pretty good, I guess. I mean, I'm just frustrated. We got all this homework to do, and, you know, I have these horrible school pictures, and I don't know when the picture retakes are. Could you fill me up on that?
Yeah, so the plan for the photo retakes is they should be here in a couple weeks. All you have to do is when they call you down, just go to the small gym and take a picture.
That's it?
That's it.
Man, my life is easy now.
What's up, dude?
Nothing much, man. How you doing?
Not too bad. How's yourself?
I'm doing well, man. Guess what?
What?
I just got my picture retake in a small gym. Oh, isn't that cool?
Yeah.
And guess what else?
What?
I'm doing pretty good, too.
Virtual Enterprise will be selling Boograms in the Commons at break from the 14th, that's today, till the 25th of this month for 50 cents each. Teachers, you can buy them for your advisory also. $5 for 15 students or less, $7 for 15 or more. These will be delivered on Halloween, so support Virtual Enterprise and buy someone a Boogram by the 25th.
The Healthy High School National Challenge is ongoing, and you can help the Student Council win the top prize of $4,000 by purchasing combo meals in the cafeteria, healthy snacks, or beverages on the challenge list. If you ever feel like doubling points, you can earn purchase a featured healthy item of the week highlighted in the student store. There are a total of 66 cash prizes to win, so let's work together to come out on top. Want to see how well we're doing? Check out the Healthy High School Challenge on Facebook for the latest totals.
Ms. Hale has been asked by the YMCA to nominate a from PHS, a YMCA teen of character. Ms. Hale is asking that we nominate ourselves or a PHS friend who they feel is deserving of such an honor. This would be someone who rarely draws attention to themselves, someone whose character extends beyond schoolwork activities, someone whose actions are positive and focused on others. Turn in your nominations to the office.
The PSATs are in this Wednesday, October 16th. If you signed up for the PSATs, be at the small gym at 8:30 on Wednesday. Juniors need to pay before Wednesday if you have not already.
The La Clinica Mobile Health Unit will be on campus every Thursday from 8 a.m. till noon. This is a great service that provides free medical care and dental care to all of our students. This is a great way to get your sports physical taken or see professional medical personnel about any issues you may be having. Please sign up with Mr. Akil in the attendance office if you would like to make an appointment for this Thursday.
If you are interested in taking a Robotics 1 second semester, you need to pick up an application form for Mr. Rose in room N206. This is the last week to get your application if you are interested in taking this class, so be sure to see Mr. Rose as soon as possible if you want to apply to take Robotics 1. Also, in other robotics news, next Monday at lunch will be a meeting in room N206 for anyone interested in starting Robotics Club. No application necessary. Anyone welcome to join. Next Monday at lunch in room N206, Robotics Club.
Any girls interested in playing basketball this winter, gym on Wednesday this week starting at 6:30.
In other news, cheerleading will be holding tryouts for their upcoming winter season. Ashley King and Jesse Leva made a cheerleading segment, so let's roll this clip.
Watch this.
Crew of Coraline are collecting food items for the food pantry at Maslow Project. The project's called Trick or Treat So Others Can Eat.
We'd appreciate any donations that you can provide. Just give it to a theater student or drop it off in the boxes by the theater board and in the commons. Talk to Miss Brown and she can have someone pick it up your donations 4th, 6th, or 7th period. This is a great cause, so let's be sure to support our thespians and helping others this Halloween season.
Over the weekend, our marching band competed in Grants Pass at the Pride of Northwest Marching Band competition, finishing in second place. Great job, Pirate Marching Band. In other College Corner news, the college fair is Tuesday, October 15th. That's tomorrow, from 8:30 to 11:30. The Wyotech Academy and Lewis and Clark University and Oregon State University workshops will be happening this Wednesday, October 16th. SOU and also the U.S. Navy will be in on Thursday and Friday of this week. The Marines will present about the scholarships they offer. Sign up at College Corner if you are interested in attending any of these presentations.
FFA will have a meeting on Tuesday at lunch. This is, if you've paid your dues before Tuesday, you will be entered in a drawing for an FFA jacket. FFA will be providing lunch, too. So don't miss out on this important meeting on upcoming events and activities.
PHS will be having a very special guest this week. Juan Felipe Herrera, a children's book author, will be talking to students during 6th period this Wednesday, October 16th. Any students interested in meeting Senior Herrera and discussing his life as a writer with him are welcome to attend. You must get permission from your 6th period teacher in order to attend. His presentations will be in the Little Theater.
The Edge will be returning to any PHS student interested in experiencing an emotionally charged workshop aimed at creating empathy and compassion amongst today's youth. The Edge workshop will be held on October 24th from 8 to 12, periods 1 to 4. So students who want to participate must have a signed parent permission slip, and the first 100 students who return the slip will be chosen for the event. Permission slips will be available at the attendance window and must be returned to the attendance window.
Over the weekend, our cross-country teams competed at the George Fuchs Classic, with our girls finishing in 6th place. Novena DeLuca finished 16th in 18 minutes and 31 seconds, adding to her school record personal best. This Wednesday at the Oak Knoll Golf Course in Ashland, our cross-country teams will be competing locally. Danny Black and Josh Langworth made a segment to show how hard our cross-country kids have been working this year to encourage everyone to go and to go to encourage our students to check out and meet this Wednesday. Let's take a look. We'll be right back.
going cross country was to have a bigger challenge in life, and it's a great sport that helps people push themselves to the edge and see what their true limits are. I started running cross country in sixth grade, like many other people who run cross country, and I've always been a runner since I was a little kid. Anyway, he never really talks much, never concerned with status, but still even is starstruck. Humble through opportunities given despite the fact that many misjudge him because he makes a living from writing raps. Put it together himself, got a picture connects. Never asking for someone's help, or to get some respect. He's only focused on what he wrote, his will is beyond reach. And now it all unfolds, the skill of an artist. For more information, if you want to learn more about cross country and how to join, you can go talk to Cornette, or you can swing by after school and come see what cross country is all about. Come see who is in cross country and what we do in cross country.
Last week, a Phoenix volleyball team lost to North Valley by a score of 2-3 on Tuesday. They followed up with that game last Thursday against KU, winning in a straight sets of 3-0. Over the weekend at the North Valley tournament, the girls won both their games. Their games this week included an away game on Tuesday at Henley and a home game on Thursday against Mazama starting at 6:30.
The girls' soccer team lost to Henley last Tuesday by a score of 1-5 and fell to KU over the weekend by a score of 1-8. The next game is today at Culver Fields against Hidden Valley starting at 4. On Saturday, they will travel to North Valley to take on the Knights.
Boys' soccer team won at Henley 1-0 in a close game last Tuesday to put up in position for... This put them in position for a league championship. They are currently undefeated in Hidden Valley, and over the weekend they played KU, winning in a score of 3-1. Their next game is today at Hidden Valley, before they return home Saturday to take on North Valley at Culver Fields starting at 10 a.m.
Our football team had an away game against Klamath Union last Friday, falling to KU by a score of 41-21. Our Pirates have two league games left this season playing football here on both our home field, starting with a game against North Valley this Friday night. Come support your Pirate football team. Hey, Riley, do you know what time it is?
Well, PHTV has been going on for a while now, so it's likely trivia time?
You're totally right. It's trivia time. Last week's question was, what was the grand prize for this Healthy High School Challenge?
And the winner is, let's see here. Okay. Ahaha! Oh, there. Just take this one. Annabelle Davis, Miss Hansen's room. And the answer was $4,000. So.
Looks like you win a $10 gift card to Subway. This week's question was: is who is the creator of the cheerleading segment? Our creators. Turn in your answers to Mr. Rose's room or to your advisors.
Well, this brings us to the end of PHTV. Be sure to join us in the plague at the Pledge of Allegiance at the end of this show.
This has been your school,
your people,
and your news.